Robert Schomburg recorded in 1838 the marshy savanna at the foot of Mount Roraima abounds in the most curious and interesting plants. Among them is an Utricularia, the most beautiful of its tribe. Stewart McPherson wrote about the first ascent. What appeared to be the route to the summit of Mount Roraima now lay before Im Thurn and Perkins, and after 10 weeks of difficult travel, they began their final ascent of the great mountain. Still, it was not clear if the breakaway in the cliff could be climbed, and slowly but steadily they approached a land that, at least as far as is known, had never previously been seen by man. Everard Im Thurn's description of the summit of Mount Roraima as some strange country of nightmares summarized his impression of the physical and biological landscapes that greeted him upon reaching the top of the mountain in 1884. Valleys carpeted with sparkling quartz crystals have been discovered on the summits of many of the tepuis. One of the largest and most spectacular of all is located on Mount Roraima, where banks of sparkling white and pink quartz crystals carpet a narrow gorge in the north of the plateau, known by local Amerindian tourist guides as the Valley of the Crystals. Thank you. The most widely distributed Guianese sundew is Drosera roraimae, which colonizes virtually all terrestrial habitat types on the summits of the tepuis, providing sufficient water and sunlight. Heliamphora nutans was the first species of the genus to be discovered. Its range consists of the summits of Mount Roraima, Kukinan Tepui, Wei Asipu Tepui, and a number of extremely small unnamed cerro plateaus on the borderlands of Brazil, Guyana, and Venezuela.